Fuck all those niggas. Tariq Nasheed, Dr. Umar, Sargent Willie Pete, all of them. Sergeant Willie Pete.
I'm going to get straight to it. So, there's going to be a divine retribution that's going to occur. I'm coming after certain individuals. As you all know, where I stand with Tariq Nasheed, him, Vlad, Academics, the man Whole Spear, and last but certainly not least, the father of the manhole spear, Suburban Whiny Pete, Sergeant Willie Pete, his damn self. Now, I have not said a word about this dude, and I've literally only made one video. Out of 300 plus videos I've made, I made one video about this dude. I was looking through my comment sections, and people said I had no valid, constructive arguments, and I was clickbaiting. Let me go and deconstruct that talking point real quick for you, nigga. I don't need to use SWP for clickbait. Why is it that you niggas never said this when he was coming at Fresh and Fit? He came at Fresh and Fit more than I came at him. Why is it that it's not clickbait when he came at Tommy Sotomayor? Why is it not clickbait when he says things about Tariq Nasheed, or he says something about Cynthia G, or he says something about Crystal Carazon? Why is it not clickbait when he does it? But when I say something one time about this motherfucker, it's clickbait. But hey, I thought you guys had a high IQ. I thought you all had been on this astute, higher level when it comes to black people. You guys were on the upper echelon. Because even Sarge said that most of his viewers are people who are successful, high value men, high value women. But y'all couldn't even do a constructive argument with a dude who is just a blue-collar worker. You couldn't even do... y'all couldn't even have a constructive argument with a guy who works at a shipping company. Works for the shipping industry. You couldn't even do nothing to that dude. I'm talking about me. Ain't that hilarious? You all listen to a dude who is projecting his own daddy issues. You listening to a dude who bitches about patriarchy, but comes from a matriarchal household. These ain't my words. These are Peter's words. These are Sergeant Willie Pete's words. These ain't my words. This nigga done fucking said that shit. You listening to a dude who says black men need to establish a male patriarchy, but agrees with 98% of what Cynthia G says. Somebody who's notorious for disrespecting black men. Somebody who would completely disregard black male authority. Oh, and another thing. For somebody who loves to big up Kevin Samuels, she done blatantly dissed Kevin Samuels in 2023. In addition to that, I got a question for you, Sarge. And all you Sergeant Willie Pete fanboys and fangirls, amazing that this guy still has people listening to him with his dated-ass talking points. Because that nigga's talking points are more dated than expired milk that's been around for 3 months. But yeah, how are you gonna praise Kevin Samuel in one breath and then shit on Tommy Sotomayor in the next breath when the guy is just a replica? He's a clean cut version of Tommy. That's all he is. There's audios, videos of him biting off of Tommy, which is a shame because Tommy bites off of other people. But yeah, as far as you though, Sarge, and his fans and subscribers, you all said that I needed to chill, but you all never told this dude to chill the fuck out when he was talking about a touchy subject regarding Tommy Sotomayor and his son. Y'all ain't never told his ass to chill then. Y'all never told this dude to chill when he had Crystal and Karazine in tears. Y'all never told that nigga to chill then. You all never told Sarge to chill out when he done said all the stuff about Fresh and Fit and how the non-Eidos blacks have something to say about melanated Americans. You all never told Sarge to chill then. You all never tell Sarge to chill when he has his long-winded ass speeches that last over an hour. And the man even said, and by his own words and mission, that he, if it was up to him, then there would be a purge going on. But I'm the one that needs to chill. Not this nigga, who has relentlessly said things about people. He talks about how black men, he basically sighed, this W.E.D. Du Bois ass, talented 10 ass nigga, basically concedes the things that black women say about black men need to step up. He's just doing it from the femboy male perspective. Yeah, I'll say that shit about Sarge. I don't sneak diss people. That goes against my belief system. You know, I know, Sarge, you're an atheist. I know you're an atheist, Sarge. And I hope you get this. But this is why I love that verse in the scriptures. I know you're an atheist. That verse in the scriptures in Proverbs 14, verse 3, where it is said that you do not spend your time around fools because they have nothing to offer you. They have no wisdom, no knowledge to teach you, which is why I don't listen to these fucking clowns like Sarge. I may listen to them to analyze, but I don't listen to them to try to gain some sort of esoteric or intricate knowledge. Shout out to Nefakari Dessalim. Shout out to College Knight. Shout out to Chronicles of Judah. Shout out to Big B Kel. Shout out to Real Nagas. Shout out to Barricade. Shout out to all the brothers out there in the world who are bringing something constructive and isn't bitching about white supremacy like this dude is. You've been talking about white supremacy since 2007. I wasn't even a high schooler at that time. I was in the fucking eighth grade while he was bitching about white supremacy. It's funny to me that this dude is still talking with his obscure ass audience. You know what the difference between me is? I got shadow banned because they find what I say to be more threatening than you, Peter. You a son of a bitch. And I mean that in the true sense of the word. I'm not insulting your mother. And that's why you say the things you say about black men, because your father failed you. And you project that onto other black men, saying that we failed the community. And what does that sound like? That sounds like these scorned black women who got some shit to say about black men because either they ain't have a father in their life or they had a fucked up relationship with their father. That's your ass, Sarge. I find it so amusing that you have so many things to say about the manhole spear. You got so many things to say about the Pookie and Ray Rays. And then, in another breath, you are saying that Fresh and Fit and dudes in the manosphere are lames. What did you also say? You also said that lead attorney and Dennis Sperling were people that you would consider to be alpha males. But I thought you didn't fuck with people who had that mindset of being passport bros, which Dennis Sperling does. Oh, I thought you didn't mess with dudes who have this black conservative mindset like lead attorney does. Ain't that funny how this dude always contradicts himself? He contradicts himself through who he considers alpha males. He contradicts himself with patriarchy and then agreeing with Cynthia G. And the worst part about it is you all lack the cognitive dissonance to even peep that shit. Because you're dazzled by his brilliance. Even though he really don't be saying shit. So, How many times are people going to recycle Nelly Fuller's talking points like you and Tariq do, Sarge? This dude lives in the hills of California, and your faceless ass lives in the suburbs of Pennsylvania. You ain't even... It's just like Ice Cube said in No Vaseline. Ain't a nigga in sight. Fuck you talking about. That's your ass. It's always funny that it's usually the so-called mulattoes or these well-off, financially well-off black men who got something to say about white supremacy and don't even stand in the premises around black people. And that's why I don't take them seriously. None of the brothers I listen to bitch and yammer on about white supremacy. And yet, they ironically would have more viable solutions for what you call white supremacy than the ones who go around emphasizing like you, Sarge. This dude ain't nothing but a hypocrite. How you gonna sit? See, why are you projecting your shortcomings onto everybody? Whether it be as black men and whatever issues that you have with your daddy, or what you have to say about the manosphere. You created them. Those are your seeds. Those are your seeds, Sarge. Those are your bastardized bastard children who have things to say about women, who have things to say about black women, and has this gender warfare mindset where they gotta interrogate. Fresh and Fit wouldn't exist without Solo TV, who I know wouldn't exist without you. O'Shea Duke Jackson wouldn't exist without you. Who else? Hell, arguably and ironically, Tommy Sotomayor probably would not exist on the level that he did without you. So stop complaining about your children and take care of your kids. But I don't expect you to do that because you a son of a bitch. And the apple never falls. The apple never falls far from the tree, now does it? This is kind of like the reverse and the invertedness of loving the fruit and hating the tree. Yep, that's it. When it comes to the manosphere, I'm like, I had a conversation with Brother Kel about this. I'm like, you know the manosphere wouldn't even exist without this nigga Sarge, right? You know that all these dudes that he complains about who sit here and talk about black women, even though you do that too, who sit here and talk about the Pookies and the Ray Rays, that's you, you W.E.B. Du Bois ass nigga. They wouldn't even exist without you. And your fans are nothing but a bunch of hypocrites with the biggest cognitive dissonance I ever came across. I thought these were supposed to be astute brothers and sisters, Sarge, but none of them were able to deconstruct anything I said. They had the floor to make me look like a goofy. They had the floor to make me look stupid, imbecilic, but they didn't do it. All they told me was how morally wrong. So they made my argument a moral and an emotional argument instead of a critical, objective, analytical, intellectual argument. Sarge, aren't you the same motherfucker who talks about how black people have the inability to critically think? But I guess that applies to your audience as well, because none of them articulated themselves in that damn video. Oh, shout out to Quest and Soul, because I know that you hate him. But don't worry, I'm sure the feeling's mutual with him as well as with me.
Stop hiding, 'cause ain't no hiding place. Said it ain't no hiding place. Said it ain't no hiding place.